Perhaps the most obvious question mark now hanging over the prospect for peace in the Middle East is here on the Golan Heights. This is the ruins of the town of Kunetra, the Syrian town which was overrun by the Israelis in the 1967 war. After the 1973 war, they withdrew to that hill over there, and they're still there in occupation of Syrian territory. Kunetra was once a thriving town of 60,000 people. It's now a decaying monument to the Middle East War, destroyed by Israeli troops as they withdrew to make it uninhabitable for the Arab enemy. Kunetra is deserted, on the edge of no man's land. The Syrian flag flies over the ruins, their last outpost on the Golan Heights. In this demilitarized zone, the UN patrols a ceasefire, not a peace. Down the road, the Star of David has been planted upon Arab soil. Syria is humiliated, but hasn't the strength alone to drive Israel out. And the Syrian army is otherwise engaged, at war in the Lebanon. 30,000 soldiers in occupation of a country in anarchy. The Syrians marched in here 2 years ago, advancing onto the battleground of the Lebanon, dragged into a war which was treated by the world as a sideshow, but which in reality was the stage upon which the tragedy of the Middle East was being fought out. But 2 years on, the Syrians are still at war in Beirut. Now, however, their sights are trained not on the Palestinians, but Christians, on the right-wing militias, which 2 years ago they saved from defeat. The Syrians now surround the last stronghold of the right in Beirut. These Christian suburbs form an almost impenetrable fortress, and therefore the struggle between the Syrians and the militias which control the streets has been fought by remote control, with rockets and mortars and shells. There's now a pause in their struggle. Inside the fortress, the streets are controlled by the sniper's bullet. It's murderous territory. The Arab world has called upon the militias to lay down their arms, to no avail, and so the Syrians are charged by the Arabs to insist. But the gunmen who police the disintegration of this part of Beirut are not struggling in isolation against the Syrians. This is the Middle East war in microcosm.
This used to be the entrance into the main commercial heart of Beirut. Since the fighting began between the Syrians and the Christians, it's been deserted, dead, and destroyed. For 4 years now, Lebanon has been at the core of the fighting in the Middle East, the crucible of the entire Middle Eastern conflict. And during this ceasefire, there's precious little sign of peace breaking out here.
At the barricades, the militiamen fight daily duels with the Syrian army. These men are phalangists, men of the extreme right whose leaders wish to regain the power they once held in Lebanon. They are also Christians, which complicates the issue even more, for this is not a united fight for the survival of Christendom. The Christians of Lebanon are so divided, indeed, that many of them regard these men as traitors, agents of Israel. For it's Israel which supplies the arms which permit the militia to confront Syria.
We are just on the front line. The Syrians are about 100 yards away from here.
That's straight through,
yeah,
there?
Yeah, straight, the cement building, just in face. They have shelled us in a, I cannot describe it how it was, but we did resist because we knew that we cannot afford to withdraw. We cannot afford to withdraw because if we withdraw, we have only the sea and we'll be thrown in the sea.
Do you expect this fighting to continue and continue?
Well, sincerely now, yes.
Israel arms the rightists because they share the same enemies. Moreover, Israel has warned that it won't permit its new allies to be destroyed. This threat keeps the Syrians bogged down here, unable to force the militias into submission without risking a full-scale war with Israel, against whose military might no Arab state can emerge victorious. Once a year, every November, Muslims go to the cemetery to remember their dead. In this Beirut graveyard, reserved for the Palestinians, it's the young who are remembered, the fighters. Without the Palestinians, there would have been no serious war in the Lebanon. The right wouldn't have fought. The Syrians would have stayed out, and the Israelis. Without the Palestinians, the great conflict of the Middle East would not exist. The Arabs have always said that this conflict can end only when there's justice for the Palestinians. But Camp David ignored these refugees in exile. The Palestinians are still in their camps. For 30 years, the parents and grandparents of these children have been waiting to return to the land which they know as Palestine and we call Israel. But the refugees are not downtrodden. They are organized and militant, and they look for leadership to the PLO. And the PLO is a power in the Arab world, not easily ignored. But Camp David did ignore the PLO, and so the PLO rejects Camp David. And that means that no other Arab state, however well disposed to Sadat, is willing now to support him, at least for the moment. The intricate and dangerous conflicts of the Middle East collide in this barren mountain range in South Lebanon, in territory provided by the Arab world for the PLO. And therefore the armies which battle for the Middle East are always circling around this land. Last spring, Israel invaded Lebanon, their purpose to destroy the PLO. The might of a modern army against roving bands of guerrillas. The fighting lasted 8 days. But the Israelis were not entirely alone. In South Lebanon, there's a cluster of Christian villages run by the Falangists, with whom, once again, the Israelis share the same enemy, the PLO. The Israelis had long supplied these men with arms and ammunition for their war of attrition against the Palestinians.
What is your relationship with the Israelis? Is it a one of tactics, or is it more than that?
Oh, we are friends, and now just like one family.
One family?
Yeah.
The Israelis did much damage, killed 1,000 civilians, destroyed their villages, and made 250,000 of them refugees. But they didn't get the PLO. The UN came in, Israel left, but 9 months later, there's still no peace.
This mountain here is controlled by the Palestinian guerrillas, and they control the whole territory behind me up north. But 300 yards away down there is the UN post. The UN are supposed to have control of all the territory from here south down to the Israeli border, the nearest point of which is about 10 kilometers away. But although the UN controls part of this territory, they don't control it all, because 5 kilometers away over the hill, the rightist forces, the Falange, supported by Israel, are still in charge, and they're not permitting the UN to carry out their mandate, which is to cover the whole region between here and the Israeli border.
The UN has 6,000 men in South Lebanon with a mandate from the Security Council to disarm the militias, but they can't do it. The rightists are heavily armed and won't let the UN into their strongholds. In practice, therefore, a strip of Lebanon up to 10 kilometers deep running along the border is still controlled by Israel. And from that buffer zone, the UN is frequently fired upon, a fact which causes the greatest frustration.
The soldiers here feel that the Israelis are certainly very helpful towards the Christian militia, in that the militia are certainly supplied with a lot of their arms and equipment by the Israelis. But as for their physical presence, where they may perhaps direct fire and that, we haven't physically seen them. It is very disconcerting. And in our mission, we are, by nature of the training that we've had for this particular mission, we do not return fire.
How much are you fired on?
Pretty regularly, in fact. At times it happens 7 nights a week.
Seven nights a week.
The UN has approached Israel to no effect. The mandate is unfulfilled, the issue unresolved. Here again, Camp David offers no solution. Not least because it's the same problem.
We strongly feel that with our experiences here for the last 8 months, our problem here, it's part of the whole Palestinian issue.
General, what would happen if your UN forces were instructed to pull out of this area, do you think?
I'm sure if you pull out, you go back to square one. You have the situation as you had in March. I don't think this
war
is good enough.
Again.
Of course, I think so.
And Israel coming in again?
I would imagine.
The Middle East is not yet at peace. Not at peace here in Beirut, or in South Lebanon, or on the Golan Heights, or in the Gaza Strip, or in the West Bank. The world is expectant, waiting for a treaty. Will it bring peace? The optimists hope so, others fear not.